And coming up, talking to your kids about the importance of managing their money. We have some tips today about teaching your children how to manage money. Financial expert Darren Weeks joins us in studio, so thank you so much for coming in.
Thank you.
So as it stands now, do you think that parents are spending enough time talking to their kids about money, or do kids get it yet?
I don't think parents spend enough time at all talking to kids about money, and I don't think our school system does at all, but it's the parents' responsibility. I don't think we spend enough time at all.
So what should we be telling kids?
Well, there's a lot of things, but what I think we should do is make sure that it's brought up, money subjects is brought up when kids are younger, just so they start to understand that the myth don't exist, like money's bad or money grows on trees, things like that. If we start talking to kids early enough about money, they'll start to understand the importance it can play in their future. And right now it just hurts a lot of people because they don't understand and how to use it.
Right, and then, oh, it's easy to get into trouble, especially especially kids who don't know, when you go to university and you get your first credit card, and then it's just a disaster from there. So
exactly. So I have a 5-year-old and a 7-year-old, so talking from experience, my kids started talking about money when they could talk. And it's good to use, you know, coins to help them with math and get them introduced to money. And I just feel that we have money in every fabric of our society, and kids are getting cell phones and things of that nature earlier than ever. They have to understand the importance of money and how it can help them, but also can harm them if they don't know how to treat it properly.
Okay, so what should, let's say we're talking, you know, a preschooler. What should we be telling preschoolers, or, you know, after, like, the 5- or 7-year-olds?
Again, just maybe just the concept of money, and I want my kids to understand that when they ask for gum or something at the grocery checkout, they can't get it because they understand it takes effort to make money.
Right.
So my little girl, Ava, yesterday, she helped me unpack a suitcase and some chores around the house. So you give her a loonie. So she now puts that into the savings account, and she's saving up money because she wants to do a lemonade stand to make more money. But she understands she has to work to make money.
Right, that you don't just get stuff.
Don't get stuff.
What about as you move into the teenage years? How much should they know?
Well, I just spoke at Jasper Place High School the other day, and I was shocked that these 14, 15-year-old kids all have cell phones and virtually know nothing about money. And then when I asked them, did they teach you anything about money in school, the answer, generally speaking, is no. But it's probably more important than calculus and trigonometry, but our school system does nothing to help our kids. So that's what I try to do, is try to talk and help people out.
And the same deal, understand that you have to work to get your money, and it only goes so far.
And then if you're smart with your money can actually grow, and if you're if you're smart with credit, it can help you. So it's really just getting rid of a lot of the myths they teach in school. Like, I disagree with most of the things they teach people. Go to school, get a job, save your money, things of that nature. That doesn't work. I do suggest you should budget and not spend more than you make. But we have to teach kids how money can actually help them. If they start at a young age getting good habits, they could be retired well earlier than the average 61-year-old Canadian these days.
Nice. So that starts with saving, obviously.
Starts with saving, more it's the habit. So my son is saving a lot of money, and if parents would just think about this concept, if you teach them how money works, he is now going to buy his own car and put himself through school, so I don't have to. It's a pretty good concept. So teach your kids about money early. It'll save you a lot of money.
Yes, that's true. And so is there some sort of motivation involved, or is it like you said, do a few chores, get a little money?
Yeah, it's, you know, do a little bit of work and see the fruits of your labor pay off. But then if you can get the kids eventually to, you know, save up something so they can have money to buy something, then they see the reward. So my son wanted a hockey stick. They're $200. Well, I'm not going to give him just $200. He had to save up for it.
Right.
So he starts to understand the value of all that work. Do I really want that hockey stick?
True.
You know?
And that maybe you want the pack of gum, and maybe you want the hockey stick, and the value of things,
right,
too, in general.
Right, because just giving your money, giving money to kids, I don't think it's going to do them any justice when they're older.
So when should they go to the bank?
6 years old, 5, 6 years old, go to the bank, and get into the habit of saving money. Later on, invest outside of the bank, in my opinion, but to get the habit of saving money early on.
Okay. So start young and stick with it. Good advice. So for more information about today's interview, you can go to our website and then click on Newslink. So thanks so much for coming in.
Thank you.
And we're back right after the break.